Feedbunk management is a crucial factor for big bales, whether we're talking about hay or haylage. And there's significant data now to show that the type of feeder that you have has a big impact on the utilization of that forage. If we just set a bale out in the field, as I see so often when I drive through the countryside, we would figure that only about 60% of that forage is consumed, and 40% is pulled out from the bale and trampled on. And once that animal defecates or urinates on it, she's not going to go back and eat it. So again, the 40% loss wasn't too bad when bales were worth $10 or $20 a piece, but now that they're worth $50 or $60 a piece, we maybe should think about managing the feeding. We can do a little bit with electric wires, and we can cut that feed loss in half if we put electric fencing around those bales over winter and allow restricted access to the bales. But the best thing is to put it in some kind of a feed bunk. The standard has been to simply put the rings around the bales. They're easy, they're cheap. But again, we're still going to have something around 15 or 20% feed loss. The most efficient way to feed is to put that bale into a bunk that is a cradle underneath the bale so that the animal reaches up to it if she pulls out a bite. And again, particularly if it is not pre-cut, the animal can chew and drop that forage in the manger and still go back and eat it. That will reduce our feed losses to around 10%, which is not too bad. So I do think at this point in time, with the higher value of hay, with the higher value of animals that we're feeding, it's worthwhile to pay attention to our feed bunk management. The other thing that I might mention on feeder management is that smaller units are preferential to a long bunk. Some of the data out of Michigan has shown that if we have a long bunk, that the lower ranking animals don't gain as much weight. What happens is that the boss animals go down that long bunk as much as 20 times an hour, every 3 or 4 minutes, and push all the other animals back. So if you have individual feeders, the boss cows can't go around everyone and push all the animals away. So what we see is that with individual feeders, we see about, again, a 10% improvement in weight gain compared to the long bunks where the boss cows are pushing the lower ranking animals away periodically. So do consider feed bunk management is a crucial thing. A cradle feeder that lets the forage fall down below will improve feed efficiency, and then smaller bunks will reduce the effect of boss cows on limiting the feed intake of lesser ranking animals. Both of those things can have a significant impact on feed utilization and animal performance.